So, what exactly is gene therapy? First, let's start with the basics. This is a gene. Genes are made up of DNA, which are the blueprints to build the enzymes or proteins that do the work for your body. As far as we know, humans have between 20,000 and 25,000 genes, and most people have two copies of each gene inherited from each of our parents. They are the building blocks of our physical makeup, from the color of our hair, to our athletic abilities, to our immune system. But sometimes genes aren't built correctly, and a small adjustment to the DNA within our genes can change how our proteins work, which can affect how we breathe, walk, or digest food properly. To better understand how genes change, here's Dr. Michelle Kalos.
So our genes are mutating all the time as a result of chemical processes in the cell, as well as external influences like ultraviolet light. We can also inherit mutations from our parents. Now, when we wind up with these mutations, they can sometimes cause disease, and that's really where gene therapy comes in.
If genes are like the blueprint to our body, gene therapy can fill in some missing drawings. Gene therapy is the introduction, removal, or change in genetic material, specifically DNA or its molecule cousin, RNA, into the cells of a patient to repair or change a gene to treat a specific disease. The transferred genetic material then changes how a protein or a group of proteins is produced by the cell. It can reduce levels of certain disease-causing proteins, increase production of disease-fighting proteins, or even produce new or modified proteins within the cell. You may be curious how a gene and the genetic material it holds is transferred to the cell during gene therapy. Well, a gene cannot be directly inserted into a cell. Instead, a carrier, also known as a vector, helps deliver the gene. Typically, viruses are used as vectors because they've evolved to be very good at sneaking into and infecting cells. But in this case, their motive is to insert the gene, or genes, into the cell. The infectious part of a virus is removed, allowing it to still enter the cell's nucleus without making the patient sick. It's worth noting there are two kinds of gene therapy, in vivo and ex vivo.
In vivo gene therapy, the genes are introduced directly into the patient's cells while the cells are still in the patient's body. In ex vivo gene therapy, cells are removed from the patient's body, then the genes are added to those cells in the lab, and the cells are then returned to the patient. The right approach depends on the disease that the patient has and the tissue that's affected, and that would tell us which is the best way to approach this.
Advances in gene therapy research allow us to treat and hopefully someday avoid rare and debilitating diseases. For more information and resources about gene therapy and how it works, go to ASGCT.org.